He does.
Clean dresses in the wardrobe, you know? She's been shopping in downtown Manhattan, you know what I'm saying? That's my New York reference for the day. So there you go. That's it. I did it.
Proud of you.
Proud of myself. Yep, there we go. Proud of myself. These two gentlemen trying to move on to face off against Odyssey in Losers Finals. And this is like an interesting case where I don't know if Odyssey will go Fox against the winner of this. Maybe it depends on who it is. But, man, they're going to be warmed up and ready for a Palutena Ditto in Losers Finals regardless.
And no matter the case, Shinji knows he's going to be fighting against yet another Palutena later on. So he's already warmed up and ready to roll.
Mm-hmm. Really explosive flame here. See what the edge play is. Both these guys, man, this is it's going to be, like I said earlier, dogfight in the air a lot. I mean, this character has a lot of hang time. Great parry right there by Utopian Ray. We saw a lot of early parries from Jen in his earlier sets, but it looks like Ray is the one catching on to habits earlier. I mean, I feel like these guys must have sets already. Do you know any of like the set counts or anything?
Between Ray and Jen, I actually haven't seen them play too often.
Ooh, okay.
They usually drop in brackets before they run into each other, or if they do, I don't believe I've seen them play now that I think of it. Even though we've seen a lot of Palutena here in New York, I can't recall seeing too much of the Ditto itself. I've seen Ray face off against lower level Palutenas on plenty of occasions, but
sure.
This is Jen we're talking about. This is someone who is climbed to the top of New York using this character, and he's cemented quite a legacy for early on in Ultimate through use of Palutena.
Definitely. I mean, if you didn't watch, you know, the house stream at the end of Smash 4, well, first off, shame on you. Second off, Jen was a very good Ryu player. Ryu, but also Sheik. It's the first stock there going to Utopian Ray. Very nice stuff from Ray. Let's see what the option is from Jen. I feel like it's so hard sometimes to hit people when you have the invulnerability. Like, I feel like it's just like a tricky thing in this game to do. Harder than it was in previous games, so I don't know. It just seems hard to get your offense started, but Jen here trying to take this first stock, see what he can find. Nice parry. I mean, he showed that back air from a mile away, though.
Like, they're both going to be poking at a distance with back air. They're both going to be trying to fish with Nair. It's really just a figure of, like, thinking ahead of your opponent. What are you going to try to do to anti-air that? What are you going to try to do to challenge it? Because one thing that we don't really talk about when we're talking about Palutena is that she can match in the air really well, but she can't really anti-air.
That was an early stock. Great recognition. I feel like Ray, too, we said this in its earlier sets, his recognition and best option choice, like his optimization of his character is very nice. That was a super early stock from Jen. Utopian Ray sending a message about this Ditto and how he feels about it.
Yeah, Ray has been playing with like a new level of confidence. You wouldn't be able to tell it just because his poker face is superb. But
yeah.
The way that Ray is able to play, he just moves smoothly. He attacks super well. He's able to play on the reversal incredibly well, whether it's out of shield or just dancing outside of the range of his opponents. He knows exactly when it's time for him to go in and how far he can get away with going on the advance.
Parry and a turnaround dash attack. Good offense from Jen. He's fighting this one back. I mean, Ray, he was towards the top blast zone, and up air is really powerful from Palu. Let's see what he can find now. Good use of the teleport there. Nice mix-up. Jen was looking for him to go towards the ledge, but he couldn't find it, and he couldn't find that up smash either. Ray now on the offensive. Let's see what he can find. Nice. That was a good attempt by Ray, but Jen was quick enough to deal with it, so.
Yeah, I mean, one thing to remember is that because this is the Ditto, they're both very aware of how they can cover each other's options. So they're constantly going for the mix-up, trying to read into the player habits, trying to not necessarily go for, like, what's going to work out the best, but what's going to work in this situation right here, right now, and how well is the opponent going to read into it? Trying to get the down tilt at the ledge. That's something I feel like we're not going to be able to see a lot of usage, just because both of these guys seem to be recovering high each time.
Yeah, she has a lot of good mix-ups, but don't forget, like, that Nair is super active, so catching her out of her teleport, it looks like both players have been looking for it. Hard to find, though, when your opponent has a couple different angles they can go in at. Here comes Jen, I mean, making quite the comeback now. It's looking real, real grim for him, but Sed is fighting his way back. He's got to find his way up this ledge, though. Good avoidance of the explosive flame. That's the way to do it, is just kind of move around it. You don't want to expend any resources. You don't want to jump. You don't want to pull an early trigger, an uppie, air dodge, anything like that. That's what the Palu wants. Jen knows that.
Like, you bring up such a good point, because, like, expending any of those resources just puts you at such a heavy disadvantage against Palutena, because she could do so much to you with so little.
Ooh, okay. Dash attack, and then into a back air. Another back air. Jen really finding some new life with these options. The shield has been so good for him coming, trying to make this comeback. 53% on Ray. Good response. Of, guess what it was? It was a back air. It's just such a good option.
Now listen, man, that's going to be the name of the game. You're going to see plenty of that shield getting the work, because that's going to get Ray the first match.
That's good. Well played by Ray, closing that one out. Because Jen, always been a player that uses momentum incredibly well since I started watching him in Smash 4. I mean, in Smash 4, he had Ryu with Rage, so like that could really work out for you. You could really take advantage of when players get scared against you, you know, it's Ryu. There's Palutena too. You saw the way Jen was able to fight back. He had a two-stock deficit. He got spiked really early in the second stock. So if I'm him, pretty sure they went back to stadium. I couldn't really see. Yeah, I would. I feel pretty good on the stage. If I'm Jen and if I'm Ray too, there's no reason not to go back here. Ray won and Jen said, you know what, you got that early KO. Let me show you what I can do. You give me a longer second stock, Ray. Game two.
I've got a good feeling we're going to see this whole set go to Pokemon Stadium. Both of these guys feel really confident moving around on this stage, and it just lends itself super well to Palutena because she can cover wide spaces really well. A lot of this ledge play that we see Palutena's strengths on is where most of the battles take place, honestly, for PS2. And then also, the platforms are spaced in a really solid manner where, like, if they can get their ledge canceled.
Really?
Yeah, you're going to see that a lot from Ray.
Nice. He's so good at that downer.
He really is.
Oh, yeah.
It's dirty. Because, like, he's such a well-calculated player, and then he goes for these vicious options, and it works. It's clean, it's well-spaced, and he just keeps on rolling with it. He doesn't let it get to his head. It's just another piece of the puzzle.
That's right. I like the word you use, calculated, for sure. You see that in his gameplay big time. Explosive flame, though. Catching Ray, not once, but twice. Ooh. That's going to take a stock again. Jen fighting his way back from a deficit. He's got to take the lead at some point, though, Hangman, if he wants to take a game.
I mean, it's hard to do so. You see how evenly matched these guys are.
It's like kind of like, I feel like Jen is better at dash attacking and Ray is better at down airing. And as you can see, down airing, you get more bang for your buck with.
I feel like it's very specific to this matchup, or at the very least fighting this particular opponent, because we know that Palutena is going to want to be in the air because that's where back air and neutral air are. But if you're getting constantly swatted out of the air, you're eating that damage for free and you're getting pelted right back down to the ground.
Job by Ray avoiding the explosive flame, went right to the ledge and was able to find his way around Jen's options. And we're seeing these two duke it out. Palutena dittos, ladies and gentlemen. You got back air and back air. You got explosive flame, but here we go. Down throw, follow up. Nice, good call out in the double jump. There you go, Jen taking the lead for the first time in this set.
Although now he's got to try to hold onto it. It's going to be difficult to do at 107%, but Utopian Ray got to figure out his way in. We know back air is going to be the option, but of course Jen knows that as well. So he's going to try and match either with his own back air or, more importantly, waiting for the recovery frames on it so he can try to go in for the punish. And we've seen that both of these players can get really strong combos.
That's right. Here we go. Utopian Ray been so good at the ledge today, especially that. Oh, Jen, I love the idea. I love it. Even though he lost the stock, even if he went back up there, he's in the disadvantage and like forward tilt would probably KO, like a bunch of options. So I love the idea of Jen saying, hey man, you've hit me with two of these down airs early in stocks. I'm going to return the favor and clean up game two with one. Very good idea by Jen. I like it. But even better defense by Ray. I mean, he's able to avoid it. And now he's in a position right here to combo Jen a couple times, get these nairs, keep him above him too. Very nice.
And it's worth reminding that this is loser semis. This is a best of three. So the pressure's really on for Jen to take this so he can bring us into a game three. Otherwise, that's it. He's done for today's tournament.
Back air, almost enough power. Now it's Ray. Oh no, the whiff grab. This could be bad. Oh my god. Ray is like psychic with these smashes. I really like what he's going for. He mistimed it, but he's gone for forward smash a couple times. And I like it because I feel like even if they don't hit, he kind of had the right read. You know what I'm saying? Like, it didn't necessarily connect, but he had a really good idea. I like the way he's thinking. Like you said, calculated. He's not throwing out smashes all willy-nilly. He didn't get to loser semis for no reason in the stack bracket.
No, yeah. There are some times when you just got to do it, but Palutena's smash attacks don't really lend themselves very well to that. They're very specifically spaced. Like, down smash is very wide, but it's low to the ground. Forward smash, it's only just ahead of her and predominantly has a wind box. And of course, up smash is literally just a line, just a thick line of light.
Right. Back to stadium for the final game, too. I mean, like you said, such a good power stage. The stage matches her hair, so that's really cool. And also, the platforms are good, or, you know, whatever. We've seen both these guys play so well on the stage all throughout the day, and Odyssey as well, so definitely a good stage for Palutena. Yo, though, it's going to be an easy punish for Jen. Let's see what he finds. Nair, looking for a scaredy cat option. Can't find one.
Yeah, no. At this point in the game, both of these guys know what they can get away with, and they got to try to minimize any type of openings that they leave in their habits. Then they have to be very aware of those habits.
It's a great spot dodge by Utopian Ray. Oh, no. The up air, very early KO. Very well played by Jen. Looks like he's going to take the lead early in this game three instead of waiting for it to happen later on.
That's something that he needs. He was able to clutch out the last match. However, a lot of it was played off of the heel. Like, if he's going to try and take away this set, he needs to just run with this momentum. Do not give Utopian Ray an opportunity to advance on him.
Forward air. Nice job. I like the pressure from Ray. Jen's going to get his jump back, though. See what he can do. Nice job with the teleport. Ray unable to find him with that down air, but he does keep him at a disadvantage, pushing him against the ledge. Great fadeaway back air. See what we can find now, too. Looking for the down tilt. Not a whole lot yet. Jen parrying his way out of the corner, though. Very clutch play.
I also like how dash attack was the immediate option out of parry, just so he can make sure he could charge forward with a safe move.
Absolutely, yeah. He's done it a couple times throughout the set. It's just really good. Nice. Good DI again from Jen. Where'd he go?
That was there cute. And he's managed to come back. Okay. It's all worth it.
He's not even a little bit worried. But Ray, firing back. They're tied in terms of stocks. This is a game three situation, Hangman. Loser of this game, going home.
Yeah, they're out of it. Someone's got to fight their way to try and duel it out with Odyssey. So even no matter who wins, they still have to get a second serving of Palutena.
That's right. Yeah, I hope you're not full. Yeah, that's for sure. There's a lot more coming out. And then the winner of that play, Sinji, which could potentially be a reset. So you're seeing a lot of Palu, that's for sure.
I hope you like this character.
Yeah, right.
That's what we're trying to tell you.
To the up air, can't find it. But this offense from Ray, it's been all Ray in the second stock. Really finding these holes in Jen's defense, able to call him out. He's catching on to his habits, Hangman.
And that's what we were talking about earlier. It's like you find these habits, you figure out how to punish. A lot of what the previous stocks were these guys trying to duel it out and figuring out what they can get away with forward air, neutral air, a lot of explosive flames.
Yeah.
But now we're going back to what the match started with, and that was a ton of dueling with back air. They're looking for that safe poke through where they don't have to worry about what the other opponent wants to throw out. Because even if it doesn't damage them, it's going to catch out. It's going to keep it safe. Neutrally going to pick up the teleport. And just like that, Ray's sitting with the lead.
Like you said, calculated. He waited that out. He shielded the explosive flame. And look at him just taking out the lead now. After that KO, now he's going to loop some more together. Jen looking for an answer here, trying to find a stock. It's good positioning, but he's got to find his way in. Looking for the up smash. Good challenge there by Utopian Ray. The forward air very quick, able to beat out that up smash. Super smart. And Ray is just playing this one by the books now. Like you said, choosing nice, safe options. Again, looking for the Nair. Trying to stay alive. He doesn't want Jen. You know, Jen takes a stock here. Suddenly, he has the momentum back. You really just want to chill if you're Ray. Don't want to throw the stock away to anything foolish. You'll take that Nair, too. You're fine. You're in disadvantage, but you're okay.
Jen's got to make a count at the ledge here. Unfortunately, he's going to dip a little too deep with the Nair, and now he's the one who's sitting, trying to come back into center stage. Ray's going to let him, though, as he's forcing a very cat-and-mouse game.
Yeah, great. Again, recognition by Utopian Ray has been amazing. Like, he saw Jen dip really low, trying to catch his teleport on the way back to the ledge, but the up tilt is going to do it. We're coming down to a last stock situation. Who's going to take it? Who wants it more? Who's hungry? And who wants to move on? Who wants to fight Odyssey? Who wants to try to fight Sinji? Looking like Ray right now, but Jen, no, he's fighting back. Good rolling, good tech rolling by Ray, though.
Look at how well these guys are dueling it out for center stage. They know that they can get the most off of this battle where they carry to the platform, they carry to the ledge, they sit in advantage. Even if they don't get their early stocks, they're racking up so much percentage. And right now, that's Jen. And he's managed to break away this deficit very well as soon as he got that stock off of Ray.
Ooh, okay. That's what I'm talking about with Ray's smashes. They are reads 100% all the way. Like you said, very calculated, very cool customer. Doesn't want to throw anything out willy-nilly. It was a great call. It didn't even KO, but it did a lot of damage. Good run-up grab for the punish. Jen controlling center stage very well with these fadeaway back airs. Pressure's mounting. That's a good option against the back airs. The dash attack, like coming in, it kind of sneaks underneath it. You've seen both players do it throughout the set. It's good Palu ditto technology for sure.
Yeah, when we keep on bringing up this back air, I'm really specific with mentioning it has that upper body invincibility. So, if you're charging at her legs and at the lower part of her dress, it's going to get caught out, and because that dash attack is safe, it's a great way to catch it out. Keep yourself safe on the approach, rack up that little bit of damage. When we're talking about damage, look at how dead even this match is right now.
Jen doing an amazing job, able to recover. Oh, okay.
Forced to air dodge. He still has his jump. He's going to be managing to come back.
Jen, I think kind of a little bit of flood there on the Nair. Great, that parry. That if he missed that, pretty sure the set's over. Explosive flame. Ray fighting his way up the ledge now. It's his turn. Can he respond? Jen looking for the back airs, of course. Nair to defend himself through the auto reticle. Very nice. Pressure up the stage. Jen forcing an option. Nair, that's going to catch him. Is that going to take the set?
That is.
Okay, okay.
Good. I thought he teleported down.
Yeah, oh my God, yeah. Okay, Jen, good job keeping your head on your shoulders. Now, look at him clutching his heart, too. What a win. Heart of a champion that he is clutching. Look at this final play here. I like the way he got a little aggressive off stage, forcing Ray to go towards the blast zone, limiting his options, fading back in, getting the old trusty, old reliable Palutena and Nair.
And that rising Nair at the ledge was not something we saw until game three. We saw it come out from Utopian Raid against Jen in the first stock, but it was an adaptation, something they held in the pocket until at the very end. And it's really good for catching teleports.